Let's take a look at a relatively new function called stock history. It is a type of dynamic array function, so it is only available in Excel for Microsoft 365. And if you're working in finance, it's quite useful because you can pick out stock prices and other information and pull it directly into the spreadsheet and then use it in your financial model or in some of your analysis. So you need to know the stock that you're looking at. It's going to ask you for the start date and the end date. So I've used a today function and I'm just going to pick up 45 days into the past, and of course we can change that. The interval, these are the different intervals you'll be able to toggle between daily, weekly and monthly. And here is the column, so we'll get into that, into which of the columns you want to show. So let's dive straight into it. So we'll start with just typing out stock history, and it's going to ask you for the stock. So we'll pick up the Microsoft value there, and the start date it's asking you for, comma, end date and interval. So I'm going to make that link so that I'll be able to change that later. And it's asking you whether you want headers or not. I do want to see headers here. And here it's asking you which columns you want to show. And you can see there for your reference that 0 is a date, 1 is a close, 2 is open. So I want all of those. So I'm just going to put 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There we go. And that's going to put all of that information there, all like that. So I can change that, of course. I can say, well, actually, I just want to look 5 days into the past. Okay, lovely. Or I might want to toggle that between looking at weekly or even just looking at monthly, like that. There we go. And I can even change that if I want to look at a different stock. So I could look at Apple, for example, and that will change. So that's how to use the stock history function. Let's take it a little bit further now and let's have a look at some currencies. So it works with these quite well. So let's say, for example, we wanted to look at Australian dollars versus US dollars there, and we want to have a look at, let's say, the Canadian dollar versus US dollar. And again, we've got our start date, we've got today's date, and we've got, let's just go a month into the past. And again, we can toggle between interval like that. So let's start there. So this time we're going to pick up B5 is the stock. It's showing what we want to show here, and the start date is here, end date is here, and the interval is that one, just like we did before, except this time we do not want a header because I've already put the headers in there. And if I close here and don't specify the columns that I want, it's going to automatically give me the date and just the close, which is what I want. Now over here I want to compare the Canadian dollar, so I'm going to do exactly the same thing. So that's going to be my input. The start date is here, the end date is here. Again, we've got the interval, except so I put in the header and I just want to see the close, so I'm going to just put a 1 this time because I don't want to put the date next to it. There we go. Think about it for a little bit, and it comes up with the Australian versus Canadian. And here, of course, we can change there, and we can see how that changes. There we go. And of course, this is going to look really nice if we chart it. So I'll just highlight the whole lot, and I'm just going to go in and insert 2 lines like that, which looks quite nice. What would look even nicer would be if I changed the colors so that they matched my color scheme. So let me just change that to, say, a nice gray, and I'll just change that to purple. Okay, that looks quite nice. It's always good as well to have the it's nice to have the labels over on the right hand side. So I'll just get a quick layout. Okay, and just make that That's a little bit confusing. I like to see these labels in the same order, so I can just quickly go in and select data, and you can just switch them around. Okay, I think that looks a little bit nicer. There we go. And I probably don't need the access title there. I can get rid of that. And what also would be nice is if I put a dynamic title. So I want this to be able to change, of course, so I can just go in and say that, and then just use an ampersand to say versus and put in my spaces, ampersand the Canadian dollars. That's going to have both of those in there. And I can just add in currency, cross rates. There we go. So that gives me a dynamic title, which I can then put into my chart. So go to click on the chart title, go to the formula bar equals A4 and enter like that. So then if I were to say, well, actually I want to look at the British pound instead, and there we go. And it just takes a little while for the chart to catch up. It's just got to think about it for a little bit, and you'll see that the title on the chart will change, and the data will eventually change as well. And it helps if I press F9. Sometimes it needs a little bit of help. There we go. So that's a practical usage of how you might like to use the stock history function in your financial models.